I have the power. I have the power? Can I have the power, please?
Whee!
Hey guys, it's that time again. Clearly, it is Medi Collector He-Man time! And that was a stupid voice, I apologize. But today I'm doing the Masters of the Universe Classics Optic figure. Standard white mailer, optic on the front, pop open the box. We got the tissue paper. And look, look, that like an eyeball to me. Booker! Now, Optic is the first figure that is being done in this toy line. His shield's already loose. That's not good. From the New Adventures of He-Man series. Now, I've watched a fair amount of the original He-Man, Masters of the Universe cartoon. I've watched most of the 2002 series. I have not seen diddly squat of New Adventures, so I have no idea who this guy is. This is one of those figures that if you just look at him, I don't know anything about him, but I think he looks fantastic and I want him for my collection. You can see, much like how Hordak had the Horde on here, he is of the Space Mutants. Optic, Space Mutant Spy for Skeletor. Now you go on his bio here, and a lot of people complain about his real name being pronounced through a series of blinks, how he has no eyelids. I've seen a movie a long time ago where these eyeball people spoke through their iris and pupil, like moving, blinking. So just because he doesn't have an eyelid doesn't mean that his entire head's an eye, for crying out loud. We don't know that maybe it can like blink around the pupil and the iris. It's possible. It's based from a cartoon show. I'm not gonna get all bent out of shape about it. But Optic, cool. The bio, I'm going to read the whole thing for once because I haven't scanned a bio in a long time. A space mutant from the foggy polar region of the planet Denebria, Optic's spyball eyeball is specifically adapted to see through the dense Denebria denebrain. Is that a typo? Because we got Denebria and then we got denebrain. Shouldn't it be Denebrian? Fog of his homeworld, making him an ideal spy. He carries a photon neutralizer, which has made him one of the most feared of the space mutants in the tri-solar system. Optic allied himself with Skeletor shortly after the Lord of Destruction defeated Hordak, and turned his ambition to the Horde Empire. Forming a coalition of mutants and outcasts to conquer the universe, Optic serves Skeletor by keeping an eye on He-Man and all of the galactic protectors of the planet Primus. Now, it's pretty cool how they're tying in the New Adventures to the original, kind of how it's not in the future, it's at the same time kind of thing. And I really do hope that we get more of the Space Mutants. So, let's open them up. And here we have Optic, and I'm kind of speechless, because this is, it's really outdone my overall expectations for the figure. He does have a couple of blemishes here and there, a couple of small defects, but I'm really liking what Mattel did with this guy. You can see his accessories. His shield here is in this very, very nice metallic silver, but the center part has not only a silver kind of smudge, but you can see it's very blotchy in one area right in the middle. But a very, very nicely painted. I really like that silver. That looks very nice. And kind of funny. I have not noticed this before, so if it has occurred previously and I've missed it, I will. But you see, made in China, if I can get it out of the light. I don't know. Made in China. Hoo-hoo, yeah. And same thing, you look on his blaster here, or his neutralizer thing, that look on the packaging. Really liking the overall sculpt of this gun. It's very, very sci-fi, very futuresque, much like if you watch like an 80s sci-fi movie. This is probably how a blaster of the future would look. Again, on the side here, China. But really do like how this was. I like how it's sculpted. I really like this gun, and I cannot figure out why. Reminds you of Flash Gordon, kind of, in a way. But very nicely done. Now on to Optic himself. And whoo hoo hoo. Now, without getting him myself, getting him from his little position, this figure looks like it's pretty much just a Trapjaw Cronus body, just painted gold and black. And I'll show more once I get all this stuff up here. But the sculpt on him is very, very down. There's his eye. I'm going to switch to the eyes because he does come with this green eye that is done in a very nice kind of look. It's got this translucent green over it, so it looks like it's an actual eye with a pupil and iris. You can reach aside and pull it off. Slides right out. And he does come with this red eye, which I like a lot more. I mean, he's a bad guy. I imagine him being red and he needs that, like, clear eye stuff. But really liking that eye. That looks a lot better. Now, a really cool thing that they did with him, you look at him and you're like, what? The newly sculpted entirely. Well, if you look on the back here, first we had this little knob, this little dial type thing. The original Optic figure had a gimmick where you would rotate the dial and the eyeball would turn in that direction. But much like with Battle Armor He-Man, all that kind of stuff, they couldn't do that, I guess. So it's nice that there's an homage of it. But you can see these nice little familiar images there. Undo those, of course. And we find that it's not a newly sculpted torso, but it's body armor. And that comes right off. And to continue, to kind of make it look like it blends in better, they've added this new little thing here. It appears to be pegged into the waist. It cannot be removed from what I can tell. But once it's back on, it fills out everything. So it's like it's just one solid piece. I really like how they're kind of changing things up. And I can see this being used in the future quite a bit. Instead of having just a bare kind of black torso. This is, of course, the trap jaw body. So the arms can still disconnect from the body. I don't know if you really would use this very often. The first time pulling it out, I felt like I was going to break it. So I'm not going to try moving this arm. Because the first time, I kind of wet myself out of fear. Thinking that this would actually snap off. But it looks like it's just the standard Cronus trap jaw body. Just painted gold. And you can see just how well it looks. Now this shows off the articulation entirely. The head is on a ball joint, rotates left and right, all that kind of fun stuff. Looks down, looks up, although the upper armor does limit some of that quite a bit. The arms can rotate all the way around, they can swing outwards, all that fun stuff. Rotate above the elbow, bend at the elbow, and the wrist can rotate. He does have his ab crunch type thing in the torso. He can rotate at the waist, although it does get kind of stiff. Legs can swing outwards, they can swing forward. This is nice and rubbery, so it is going to bend with him. Bends back pretty far. And of course, he can rotate. And his knee, of course, can bend. And his ankles have that whole nice little hinge thing. This ankle is very, very loose compared to the other one. It's, you know, it's okay, but this one's just wibbly-wobbly. Got to put his armor back on him. It slips right on. I like this. It just pop it right back on. And then when you do, you can see how this fills out everything, and it looks like it's one solid piece. That's a really, really nice idea, and I'm glad Optic looks as good as he does, frankly, because kind of take a gamble. I don't know this guy, so I don't know if I really care for his bio, but that looks fantastic. You can see his eye, of course, is limited in its movement. You can have it look up a little bit, look down a little bit, and it can still rotate, but you can't have a lot of that movement that it did before. The ab crunch is still there. Man, I just really, really like this guy. And I'm, you know, being that this is the first figure from the new adventures that they've brought out, I'm really looking forward to what they could do in the future. I don't know the characters, so anything that they announce is new to me. But this guy looking as good as he does, I'm okay with buying more new adventures figures. Optic really does look fantastic. And I would say, even though he is sold out, I think, at the moment, if they ever do reissue him, if you could find him through Big Bad Toy Store, eBay, all that kind of stuff, I would say pick it up. It's a very, very well-made figure. The sculpt is nice. The body armor itself over the torso is intricate and interesting enough that it makes it look like an entirely new figure. I really didn't even kind of notice that it was the Cronus body until I pulled everything off, and it's like, oh, the arms come out. But that is it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you have a great day. I will see you around. Take care.